This is the wreck penetration training dive in my 4-dive series of wreck and cavern training. As we're going down, you can see me setting the set point for my rebreather from the shallow setting of 0.7 bar PPO2 to the deep setting of 1.3 bar PPO2. I'm doing that both on my dive computer and on my rebreather's controller. You will have heard the beep from my rebreather and can see the high oxygen warning. This is triggered when the oxygen goes above 1.6 bar partial pressure of oxygen. There was only a short squirt, and that triggered intermittently while the O2 mixed within the loop. It didn't continue. You could see that the numbers went back down at some point to 1.6 and it evened out at 1.3 bar. So, not to worry in this case. Viewer discretion is advised, as some portions of this video include low visibility sections at depth. You can see the hatch in front of us that we will be entering. Every penetration dive needs a line solidly anchored outside, so as when we need to come out, we can follow it. Got to remember our cookies. And in we go. The thing you'll notice about wrecks, after all, just walk through your house and you'll see what I mean, is the distinct lack of attachment points. If you had a string that started at your front door and you needed to tie it off so as you could freely move through your house, where would you tie it to? What points on the walls, the ceiling, or the floor would you be able to attach the line to? I've got a buddy. Here's Max. Maybe he can help me find some point to tie on to. There we go. There's a good spot. It's against the wall. It means that the line is clear as you're coming in through the hatch, rather than going diagonally across the hatch. So, we'll use this to tie off. Throughout the rest of the video, why don't you watch carefully to see where you would tie off, and then compare it to where I tie off at each particular point. We want to clip off our stage cylinders here, so as that way we're not carrying the extra bulk with us throughout. Remember, a stage cylinder has high oxygen gas for accelerated decompression. While it may physically be the same as a bailout cylinder, the bailout cylinders will remain with us in case we need to get off the loop in a hurry and need something to breathe. For our bailout cylinders, we need to breathe them right then, right there. For our stage cylinders, we can go and get them. Not a problem if they're left behind. After all, this is the way out. We will be passing them on our return. Did you notice the orientation of that cylinder? Did you notice how the bottom of it was floating up and the top of it was at the bottom? Well, that's normal. The pillar valve and the regulator are solid metal. The rest of the cylinder is aluminium. So, aluminium being neutrally buoyant and the gas inside there being just a little less dense than the water means it is slightly buoyant. It sits on the bottom. It faces the wrong way, but it doesn't lift us up or down while it's still full. Well, that was a bit of a squeeze. While editing this, I did notice the hinges. But while in the water, I didn't really notice them. So, hey, I'm tying off here instead. This is, not the best point. But it's stable enough. It's going to stay there. It's not going to move around without a lot of pulling. And, well, we don't pull on the golden line. We use it as a guiding point. So, this'll do. Yuri had said, go from the bow to the stern, finding an interesting route. So, hey, up, down, left, right. Any change in direction's good, right? Well, let's see how we go. Maybe not that way. Yes, that could be a spike. Not such a good idea to swim right into it. And down we go. Oh, doesn't this area look clean and pretty and bright, and nothing could go wrong. Of course, if I could only find somewhere to tie the line onto, where would you pick? So the viz there has gone from broth to pea soup. Oops. That would be about the size of a small coat hook. I was thinking, let's take it up high so as we can get out. Nope, Yuri wants us to stay in and take it along the bottom. too tight for me. But Yuri's saying if I unclip my bailout cylinder and push that in front of me, I'll be able to go through. Just watch. See? Made it through. No problem. Guess what time it is? Yep, that's right. Lost line drills. And, well, you can see there's not much viz here, so I'm not sure how much it's making a difference, me pushing the blindfold on, and how much it would be if I didn't have that on. But hey, you're probably going to get a similar view as what I had at the time. Couldn't find the line going that way. And to think, this section was so light and airy and open when I first came into it. I found a corner! And that arrow says, go the other way. Okay, drill over. I found my way out. Or at least, I would have found my way out. The dragging each other through on our bailout was a little bit more challenging on this particular one. Yep, watch for yourself. Think about how you might do it if you were in this position as we undo the line here. I hope you've enjoyed.
out the line.
Note the detail on the rebreather controller on my left arm. We've got 53 minutes time to surface. We've got a ceiling of 14.5 meters. And we're currently at almost 30 meters down. Yep. And if you look at my right hand, no, that's not some seaweed growing out, as much as it may look green. I actually scratched my hand. And the growing seaweed is just a bit of blood coming out. Pay careful attention to it, and you'll note how it sort of looks like a bit of seaweed growing there. Yeah, I thought it was interesting.